Hi, and thanks for watching. In this video, I'm going to just go through how I'm setting up for a memorial service. This one happens to have several elements. One is going to be a loop of videos with lyrics, and the other is going to be some live music. We don't have a slideshow on this one, so that part will be pretty easy, but typically we'll have some kind of slideshow or a movie or something like that. But in this instance, that's not what we have. So the challenge here is that with the videos, I want to add lyrics to them. They wanted lyrics on the videos, and they wanted actual videos played. So what I'll have to do is set up a way to loop those videos in the beginning with the lyrics. And so you're going to see me kind of puzzle that through and figure that out. Typically, what I would do for any kind of video is create a media playlist, and then that media playlist can loop. You can set it up to just go to next, just like you would an audio playlist, and those videos will loop and play through. The problem is that they don't have lyrics on them. So what I may end up doing is actually recording the videos with the lyrics, and then I'll be able to set that up as a media playlist. So it'll be kind of complicated. I'm not going to subject you to the whole process, but I'll show you some of the key steps, and then I'll edit out some of that stuff later. But this is kind of a live look at how I'm doing this, and hopefully you garner something from it. And then I'm going to go through how we'll actually run it on the day of. So first thing I'm going to do, and what I've already done, let me just show you what I've already done, is downloaded the videos that they wanted, so the songs that they wanted, and I use this 4K video downloader. It's actually worked really well for me. There's always an update with it, but it worked well. I don't think I paid for it, but I think maybe there was it could have been like $50 or something, but it's been well worth it. And I know there's going to be some copyright things, and people are going to comment below, hey, you can't do that, copyright. One of the things I'm going to do is put up just a message on our live stream that, hey, there's copyrighted videos and stuff playing right now, so we can't broadcast that, but we are going to live stream early on enough that people can tune in and they'll be able to see the service. So we do have the ability or the copyright license to broadcast our live music. So we should be covered there. So in any case, we have a couple of songs here that need to have lyrics added to them. If you'll notice, I put a pretty small font on these. So I'm going to kind of see how that looks in the main sanctuary, but I wanted to get out of the way of the video, and I think it's going to be good enough. People aren't necessarily going to be singing along in a worship service with this, so we just want to get the information on the screen. So in any case, with the timeline, basically what you'll do is you click on this icon up here. You have your timeline icon, and then you can add different types of media. So you can add an audio track, or you can add a media track. And this layout is actually new to 7.10. They had some issues in the rollout of that, but it's been okay. So I'm going to grab this right from there, drop it in, simple as that. And then basically all I do is go back here to the beginning here, and then I will hit record, which arms the recording. Okay, so it's just ready to go. And then when you hit play, you'll be able to put in your cues. So I'll go ahead and do that now. So I'll cue that intro, bring it to the front. Now I can't hear the music right now, and that's because of the way I have the audio set up. So I'm going to have to change some of that. All right, so just kind of for your edification, I don't know if anybody's familiar with this. This is loopback. It's a virtual sound card. It routes audio, and it's become an essential part to my setup. I really like it. And so I'm able to set up my Propresenter out. It's coming through on this channel 1 and 2, and I have it set up. This is my monitor for our computer here. I could do the external headphones, and then I have it going out to our soundboard as well. But all I have to do is turn that on, and I've got some audio to listen to. So I kind of forgot that I had that set up, and so I just wanted to show that real quick. So I'm going to go ahead and set up this video, like I said. And actually, why don't I just show you? So I'll go back to the beginning here, show you at least the first couple of slides here. Hopefully you can kind of hear what's happening with the music. So we get that first intro slide. I can edit it so I can just drag it back to the beginning since I didn't get it right away. Then I'm just going to let it play through and trigger the slides like we normally would. Oops. Let's see here. Let me go back. And we should be able to jump around. Yeah, so you can kind of loop back and jump around. And for some reason, that killed the audio. That's weird. All right, so one thing that I forgot about is that when you're using a video and it comes in as foreground, then what it's going to do is as soon as you click on a slide, it's ProPresenter is going to be like, oh, you want to put this slide out front now, so it's going to kill your video. So you have to, I tried going through here, through the inspector, because a lot of times you can change that where it's set, the behavior of it, and it's just not here in the inspector. So what I'm going to do is delete that, and then we'll set video as it imports, we'll set it to background, and then that should bring this video in again. When I bring it in, it should bring it in as background, and we'll use existing. So hopefully that's the case. Let's try it. All right, so got it working. I had to go back and put in the video again. I had to like get rid of the video that was in the assets. So if you go here and go show in Finder, it shows it up and shows it in the assets. So in any case, that's what I had to do, but now it's in the background since I set that import to background. So for whatever reason, when I said use existing, it it didn't set it to the background, so should be good now. I'm going to go ahead and go through this process, and hopefully we'll see you on the other side here. But let's start here. We hit record, get playing. Of course, it's not playing again. All right, so basically I gave up on the timeline. It's just not functioning right. I'll hit play, and it just, you know, it's doing this weird freeze frame. It's not starting at the right time. It's just all goofed up. And the main thing is the point of the timeline is to have lyrics display. And despite having everything set up correctly, it's just not displaying those lyrics. So I'm going to take a different tactic with this. Like I said, I'm going to have to record it anyway. So record it as a video, that is. So I might as well just get rid of this. And then since this is set up, what I'll do is add the video to this first slide. And once that's in place, I should be able to just do this and see if that video plays. All right, so as you can see, I'm just finishing up recording this. And basically what I ended up having to do is just place the video in this first slide so that it starts on time. I did time it with these, but the timeline feature is just pretty messed up right now. So hopefully they get that fixed before long, and we'll be able to use it in the future. But for now, that's what I had to do. So I'm going to go ahead and stop capture on this. Yeah, just ran into some pretty major difficulties with that. And it's just because it's buggy. I'm not sure if it's me or if it's their stuff, but I would think they wouldn't release this if they were having those kinds of issues with timeline, especially since they were focused on redesigning it. So basically, I kind of found a little bit of a workaround, which I was going to do anyway. I was going to record these videos so that way I can put them in a media playlist here, and then I'll have to just set it for a loop. So I'll show you what that looks like. So basically I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of these and then show you what that looks like. So again, we'll see you in a minute. All right. So I've just finished recording the last song. It's My Chains Are Gone. I couldn't find a really good video of this. So basically what I decided to do is grab something else. At first I looked at scenery and that kind of thing. And then I thought, well, let's try this, The Chosen. And I got to tell you, it is pretty powerful to see this clip of, and you might be familiar with it, but it's this clip of Mary Magdalene just being grabbed by the overwhelming forgiveness of God. It's pretty awesome. So in any case, pretty impactful. So put those together. Basically what I did was ran the music and ran this clip right here so that it'll kind of line up together. But I'm going to go ahead and stop that, and maybe I'll post that separately. I'd like to put a better looking lyric to it if I can. But in any case, now the task shifts, and we're going to start adding some lyrics and music into a playlist. So there I am. All right, so we're going to go first of all to this plus icon, of course, and add a playlist. And I'm going to, I'm just going to give it a generic name out of respect for the people that I'm preparing this for. And then I just need to add our items. So, and there's a couple of items that we're doing live music to. So I'm going to go ahead and add that to playlist. And then, all right, so one day when we all get to heaven, add that to the playlist. We're going to get our arrangements here. And those should be the same as before from the last time we did this. I'm also going to create a couple of presentations. So I'm going to call this the procession, and actually I'll call it memorial. And so basically I want this to be, I'm going to use a slide that lets people know on the live stream that we aren't airing the videos. So I'm going to get something that'll give me a message. It doesn't really matter, but maybe something with looks pretty official. That'll probably work. So we'll use that. And then everything else looks good, except for we'll add it to this, and we will duplicate. Nope, did that wrong. Go up here, and duplicate that. There we go. Now we have a separate item. So if you do it the other way, it just adds the item twice to the playlist. So we're going to call this the pre-session. I think that's how you do it. There's the pro, session. So, little known fact, I can't really spell very well. So, it is what it is. But I'm pretty good at writing, ironically. It's just I rely a lot on spell check. Anyway, so we'll try it both ways and hopefully that'll be okay. All right, so drag this into our playlist. And there it is. And we'll put that pre-session at the top. And now what we need to do is add our text. So go edit slide. The service will begin shortly. I think I'm going to grab that, unlock it. There we go. That's the problem. Open that up a little bit. Open this up a little bit. Bring this down. Line it up. And copy origin material. I don't know if that's a word. So this is just to give people an idea of why they're not seeing anything on their screen. I probably would put a timer if not for the fact that we don't always stick to the timer. We're pretty good about starting on time, but frankly, we just don't always stick to the timer. So we'll just leave it as is. All right. And the next thing we want to do is create our playlist. So we have our slides ready. And then we're going to get our playlist ready. So I think what I'm going to do is do it as a smart playlist. Get rid of that box around my head, maybe. There we go. I'll do it as a smart playlist. So I'm going to take the videos that I recorded from, and I recorded them to Propresenter. I recorded them to disk, I should say. And so I'm going to go to our where we record, and of course these are all from today, and then I have this duration set up, so I know a couple of these I started over, so I'm just gonna get rid of those. I can kind of see which one this is. Let's see, I can only imagine, so I'll just rename it. I should probably just fast forward here. All right, so I've got all those kind of towards the top here where I can start to organize them. So I know for sure that this How Great Thou Are art and Amazing Grace are the latter of the, it's the procession at the end. So I'm just going to make a new folder out of these and we're going to call it Memorial Procession, and then we'll there. And that may be too close in name to really be good, but that's all right. So now we have our two folders that we can turn into smart playlists, and I can order them in the way that we want. Depending on, I'm pretty sure I can do it in here, so we'll do that. All right, so come up here, add smart playlist with that plus icon by the media playlists. Go down to where our folders are, and let's start with the procession. And now these are loaded in, and right away I'm going to make these a background. We want them as a background because we want that slide to play. So the slide that we created here, we want that to play. We want these to go to next. So let's see here. Oh, don't tell me. Yeah, here we go. Next. So these should now play in order, and they'll just loop back on each other. So while I'm here, what I'm going to do is set the start time on these, because as I captured these, I didn't always start the song right away. I started the capture, and then I started the song. So I'm going to find where the beginning would be. So that first frame, that's a little slow for me. Now, what I probably should have done as I was doing this was, so I know that that's my first frame, and looks like I did okay stopping this one as well. So hopefully that's all right. I guess we'll test that one too. But what I was going to say is what I should have done was check the audio at the same time. So typically what I like to do is kind of get a sound check on this. So I look at my VU meter here, and I'll turn this down a little bit. I don't need that. But I look at my VU meter here, and I just try to see where I'm at. This, I can already tell, is going to be too quiet. So I'll hit it again. And then, since this will probably be my lowest one, I'll pretty much get everything to this level. So what I try to do is just get something on my screen that I can mark that level. So like this, I'll say, is my marker. And then I go back through here, and we'll play that one. All right, so I know this is like riveting information, but this is just the process of how I go through and I'll sound check videos. That way I don't get any surprises. So I'm going through the service, and you know, if I have one video or one song that's louder than the other, it can be pretty jarring for people in attendance. So I try not to let that happen. So now that I have my playlist, what I can do is add this playlist to the slide. And if I'm not mistaken, I think you can just drag it in there. Yeah. So now when I go to play this, here, let's clear it out. So now when I hit this, it should start both. And there you go. So this will loop until you end it. So what I'll probably do then is I'll put one of my clear actions. So let's use this. Yeah, doesn't let you drag those. That'd be nice if you could do that. But we'll do a clear action of some kind. So we'll put that there maybe, and get rid of that slide, that edit, that box, I mean. So let's just unlock that. Get rid of all that. All right. So now we have this music macro, which will automatically change everything over for this, for the lyrics, so that the lyrics display correctly in-house. And this is on the live stream, but the lyrics will display correctly in-house. And yeah, so that should work pretty well. But what I want is this slide here to go to the live stream, and for there to be no audio or anything, no video on the live stream. So this just lets people know, hey, there's copyright material being displayed. And so what we need to do is set up a look. And so I've got a look that I started working on. And with that, I want just the slide going to the live stream. And then if we go over now to the live stream, all they'll see is this, and then we just want to check that the music is not going out to the live stream as well, and that's where we could run into some issues. So there's a way of resolving that, and basically what I'm going to do is take 7 and 8 off of the live stream, because we rarely ever use that. I use it for just playing out of music, you know, the Apple Music. And so I'll use 7 and 8 for these videos and route the sound to 7 and 8, and then I'll test it. We'll record to disk again. All right. So basically, stop that playing. So we'll go to the inspector on these. We already did our sound check. Go routing 7 and 8. And then we'll be able to route that into the house. And the reason I'm doing it this way is because I really don't want to change too many settings. I'd rather have things stay the same. So I'm going to be gone actually. And what I don't want is for them to have to come back in here and reroute some things. So that would be pretty bad. So really I'm just going to do 7 and 8 here. And then they shouldn't, our operators won't even notice that it's different really. So I'm going to go to loopback and just double check that that is all correct. So I have our Propresenter out routed and I do have, see, I have 7 and 8 routed to 3 and 4, which is where we typically play our background music. So that'll be fine. We'll just leave it there. We won't put it on video. All right. So that's basically how I'm going to set up this playlist. And one last thing. We do have to add the action of putting the look. Let's see here. And sometimes I'd create a whole macro for this kind of thing, but I'm not going to bother with that. And then I'm going to add a, there we go, stage. All right, stage. And I will change this to, I'm going to change it to probably to sermon because I think that has the right timers and stuff. But it's basically the sermon one just displays what's on the screen. So now if I hit that, yep, sure enough, it displays on both. This gets nothing. My audio's on 7 and 8, and that's going to go out to my soundboard. And yeah, should all work just fine. And then when they're done with the looping memorial procession here, this playlist, all they have to do is click this and it'll switch everything back so that they're ready to go for music. So this will be their stage display. This will be the live stream and then in-house. So pretty good way to do it. And of course, now we have this guy down here, and we're going to do basically the same thing with that. All right, so in this portion of the video, what I'd like to do is just go over how we're going to run it on the day of. And this is where it gets maybe a little bit complicated as far as making the video. Because I've got to sort of show you what I'm doing. So I'm going to get this camera up here and... let's see, let's just go to that one. All right, hi. So let me back this out. And we have some camera control with our iPad here. So basically what we'll do is we can do a couple things. I have our joystick control, and it's just on Ethernet, so that can be dragged up here and kind of placed in a convenient spot. Out of coffee, that's a shame. We can place it up here in a convenient spot if we need that, and that'd be okay. But basically, we'll use the iPad app, and actually the guy that's going to be running this particular service has his own iPad that he likes to use, so he can do that. And then our sound guy typically will run lights and stuff for us on this one anyway. All right, real quick here. One thing that I forgot to mention is the youth group plays in the background here is that we can set up a preview screen that gives us both our cameras, gives us some timers for video countdown, audio countdown, and that's simply accessed under previews here. But what I'll do is set up the previews screen with this local cam ops for special services. So it's named pretty specifically. That's basically the hardware setup. is getting our iPad in place so that we can control the cameras. And then I'll try to zoom. Well, I don't need to zoom in. You guys can see my whole screen. But we have this right here, the camera one and camera two. So he can use that. Or on the keyboard here, I will actually zoom in on that. We have our hotkeys. And so, and get that into frame here. We have camera one and camera two hotkeys set up. And these are actually just all our macros. So camera one and camera two have that. And of course, that goes back to when we were queuing our cameras with MIDI notes, because they made that possible at one point before getting the Elgato Stream Deck integration or whatever. So in any case, that's how we kind of got our camera operator off the main display and over onto a different display, which I could show you, but yeah. All right, so that's pretty much it. This is just going to get started. We'll have to set up the YouTube, so we'll make sure to go to YouTube here, and just like any other service, dismiss that. We'll edit and we'll retitle this. So instead of ABC Live and all of that, we'll put you know, the memorial, the name of the individual, and then we'll do a public. Sometimes for funerals, what people like is an unlisted. So unlisted basically means that you have to have a link in order to find it. You can't search for it. Private means that we have to have their email address, and it has to be a Gmail address. So it's unlisted is the way to go with that. And what you can do is just share it with one of the members of the family. So when you get it up and started, you can go and grab the link and share it with a member of the family, and then they'll distribute it. I've tried to do that myself, distributing the link, but typically there's just too much going on and I don't have all their numbers, or it goes to junk, or, you know, whatever. So I just don't do it that way anymore. I give somebody in the family the link, and that's worked really well. And then public, obviously, they can search for it. So probably this one's going to be public. I'm not going to set it up right now, but you'd also go here and do special services. So we have some different playlists, and we'd put it in special services. Sometimes I would change this. Just depends on if I have a picture. I'll probably just leave it. It's fine. So in any case, that's pretty quick and easy, but it has to be done. And then at a certain point, you start the live stream, and then you, once it's started, this will shift over to a different kind of screen, and then you'll have the option to grab the link and or to share the link. In fact, it might be up here. Anyway, it's somewhere. You'll see it, and you grab that link, copy it. You know, you can paste it into an email or paste it into a message and then text it out. So that's pretty easy to do. All right, so that's pretty much that service set up. You know, this, most of this stuff is, you know, one or two clicks, or just regularly running lyrics like you would on a Sunday morning. So that's not too hard. You know, with the camera, you want to set up a few presets. Like on the app, you'll set up a few presets and just rely on those presets. Nothing fancy. Nice shot of the podium, nice shot of the table up front. You know, so we'll do with one of the cameras a shot of the table up front, and then maybe a couple of wide shots that will capture the musicians. So in this one in particular, we're just having piano accompanying a vocalist. So should be pretty straightforward. And beyond that, I mean, it's just making sure you're you know, using the blank screens and stuff like that when needed. And that should be it. So start the live capture on time and all that, and you'll be okay. So yeah, so I think that's it. Let me switch cameras so I can say goodbye to you. Thanks for watching. This one was a little bit difficult. Ran into some things, but and certainly didn't script anything. And because I'm sort of setting it up live, I just wanted you to see a little bit of the process that I go through. There was some troubleshooting involved, and I didn't show a lot of that. I'm going to edit it out because, it, frankly, you just don't want to sit through that. But we did run into some issues where the video wasn't working on the timeline, so you just sort of shift gears and make it work. I wanted to use the slide layer for the live stream. I could have done that a different way. I could have used slides on the, you know, the actual slide layer for the lyrics. I didn't want to do that because I wanted those videos to play in a loop, and there wasn't really a good way to set that up when you have separate songs. You can't set them to loop. So I thought, well, I'll just record it with the lyrics as a video, like we would a live stream, capture it, and then bring it back into ProPresenter and play them as videos. So, you know, there's some creativity involved when you're doing stuff like this. You know, and the biggest thing is, like, you know, I could have just said, look, I'm going to find some lyric videos, or, you know, I'm going to find, or I'm just going to say, no, I'm not going to do it. And, you know, we don't have it, so we're not going to do it. But especially with memorial services, I really like to step up and give them whatever they ask for. So, you know, if they want overflow room, even though I think there's only going to be 20 people here, I set it up. You know, if they want lyrics on videos, I set it up and I do it. And I try to do the best I can in the time that I have, you know. So it's definitely something where, you know, if I was in their position, I wouldn't want to have to worry about stuff like that. And I would want it the way I want it. And, you know, that's fine. That's good. People need to feel supported in that time. And as a tech person, as a worship leader, I feel like it's an opportunity to minister to people in a small way. And so I always, you know, whenever I talk to families, I always tell them, hey, whatever you need, whatever I can do to help, that's what I'm going to do. At the end of this, what I'll typically do is we have these, I bought some little flash drives. They look like keys, but I bought these little flash drives, cheapy flash drives, and I will take the service and load it onto that flash drive. Sometimes I get, in fact, this flash drive right here is from a family. So I will use their flash drive if they have it, but otherwise I'll load the service onto the flash drive and I'll give it to them. And, you know, that's been pretty well appreciated, you know. So it's something I do. We try to do as a church to serve those who are grieving. And, you know, I've been in that situation too, where we wished we had recorded. It was my grandmother's funeral, and we didn't record it, and the church didn't think to hit record, even though they're set up for that. Not their fault. I'm not, you know, upset with them or anything like that. But pretty much from that point on, I was like, no matter what, even if they don't ask for it, or even if they say, no, I don't really want that, I still at least record it to disc, because they may later on say, hey, did you, and I've had that where they go, hey, did you happen to record? And, no. So we, or I did happen to record. And so I just do it by rote now. And I think it's a good practice to get into. So in any case, that's this video. I know it's maybe a long one, but, you know, at least there wasn't a slideshow. If there was a slideshow, it gets even longer, but, I've been working on putting it together, a video on how I do slideshows, and it's a bit of a process, and it's kind of hard to make a video on that. So, I will get that out when I can, but I try to do these as in depth as possible, because my whole point in this channel is that you guys see some of the complexity simplified. So you see some of the possibilities and the different things you can do, but it's very much step by step, and I try to make it as simple as possible. I think a lot of the training videos out there sort of assume a level of knowledge that, you know, especially if you're a volunteer tech person, you don't have time to dive in to all of this. So hopefully you pick up some principles on along the way, and you can get some of your own creative solutions. But you can also just follow kind of step by step through this process. If you have any questions or if you need any help with anything, I'd be happy to help when I can and where I can. Definitely comment down below, get in touch with me, whatever you need to do. All right. Thanks for watching, and have a good one. God bless.